Hi friends, this is Darshna Savla here on behalf of Dress My Craft. A very warm welcome to the very beautiful new world of Transfer Me. And today I am going to show you all the basic tips, tricks and techniques on how to use this beautiful newly launched product by Dress My Craft, that is Transfer Me. Transfer Me sheets come in a size of A4 size. And you get nearly say 6 motifs, 7 motifs, 10 motifs, 13 motifs and endless different motifs with a variety of design. They are used for your embellishments. They can be used for scrapbooking, for card making, for mixed media, for decoupage, and the world is endless. And we have a very beautiful collection right from vintage elements, masculine figures, vintage queens, for the kids and also for your kitchen accessories, for your fruit, trays, vegetables and endless. The variety of designs is in a very huge number and you can really mix and match this with all the possible mediums that you have. So let's get started creating this very beautiful transforming projects and I will show you all the basic tips, tricks and techniques. Before I move on to showing you all actually how to use a Transfer Me, let me give you all a little bit brief introduction about Transfer Me. Transfer Me is a very simple to use. You have to simply use water to transfer it onto any of your surfaces. You do not need any specific glues, gels or mediums. That's the reason why it is super simple to use and super easy to use for anyone with very minimal supplies. So the basic supplies that you really need are, first of all you need the fussy cutting scissor, a very sharp simple fussy cutting scissor. Then you need the brushes. You also need a muslin cloth or you need a sponge. You need a clean glass bowl of water. That's it. It has, you really require very minimal supplies. And coming to the bases. The bases can be used any mediums. For example, I have done this on a wine glass. So you can do it on a crystal clear glass. You can also do it on a candle. You can also do it on these glass bottles, milk glass bottles. This is a metal tin. This is an MDF box. This is also an MDF box. This is an MDF visiting card holder. This is an MDF pen stand. And here all the projects that I have done are also on the MDF basis, which have been painted with different textures. And on the other side, you see the coffee time tray, it has been done directly on the pine wood. So you need not paint the wood before doing your any of your transfer projects. You can directly use raw bases to make your transfers. Isn't it easy? It is super duper easy to use the transfer sheets on any bases with painting or without painting or without giving any specific textures. And let's get started. To begin with the Transfer Me, the very first step that we really need to do is cutting. Cutting plays a very important role in your Transfer Me. So exactly how you will go about with the cutting is, for example, if I have these kind of designs, you know, where there is a specific outline given. So if I require an image which requires a black frame, I will cut outside the frame. If I require the image where I do not need the frame, I will cut inside the frame. But many a times I may need the image edge to edge exactly in that shape. I do not require an extra frame. For example, if I have done the transfer on this bottle, I have very minimal Transfer Me on the edging. So in that case, I will go a little cutting nearby, neck to neck. So now, how will you do that? The very important step is, you just leave around 1 mm to 2 mm space around the boundary and you can see you will get very beautiful result. It is very important to make sure that your scissor is steady and you are actually moving your paper when you are doing fussy cutting. Go around the edge of the design exactly leaving 1 mm or 1.5 mm to 2 mm space as much as a little bit closer by you can. Do not leave too much of a space around. So this will make the work super easy and very neat and very elegant. And you will see a very crisp transfer once you have finished it. So these are very important basic tips that you must follow when you have to start with your Transfer Me. So once you have finished around the edge, there will be one side which I will leave a little bit more extra space. The reason being, when I am going to separate the film on the top of the sheet, which is kept for protection, I need some space to pull out. So when I try to pull out, there could be some tackiness on the base which might come onto your hand and your print could get spoiled. So for that, what I will be doing is, on the top, this is the place where I can afford to leave a little space more, where I will be actually holding it. And now what I will do is, I will leave this space and I will complete my fussy cutting exactly around edge to edge in the remaining area. This is a very important step, leaving a little extra space which will help you to hold this picture and help you to peel the film that is stuck over it. So cutting plays a very important role, and you can see all the cutouts that I have already pre-cut here down, and I have left some good enough space everywhere to hold it. For example, if this is a crown, I have left a good enough of space here to hold it with my fingers. If it is a flower, I have left some space here. The most important thing is this butterfly. If it is a butterfly and the antennas over here, must leave a little space in the center, so which will not help the antennas not to tear. So this is how you complete the first step, that is fussy cutting. And once we are ready with the fussy cutting, we will see the beautiful magic. To see the magic of this transforming, first of all, I have taken a tea coaster. This is an MDF tea coaster to which I have given 2 coats of chalk paint. And now on this, I will be transferring this beautiful transforming image. So the very first step that you would be doing is, you will lift this transparent film that is kept on the sheet and separate it from the base. And you hold this place here, which you had left extra, which will help you to easily peel off the transparent film which is kept on the sheet for protection. So we keep this transparent film aside and you flip over the design, making sure that the printed part goes directly down into the water bowl and the print is reversed down, making sure also that the print is completely immersed in water. The paper should not come out of water and this should be inside the water bowl only for 10 seconds. Hardly a 1 or 2 seconds more you can keep, but it has to be inside for 10 to 15 seconds on the higher end, not beyond that. And now it's the time to remove the image from the water bowl with the help of a tweezer, if you can use it, and make sure that you remove all the excess water down here into the bowl, and very gently place this design right in the center of your base. You're like this. Once you have placed the design, make sure that you dab this design with the help of a sponge so that excess water comes off into the sponge. This will make sure that your transforming sheet will not get any creases when you are going to slide it out. Also, before we slide off the paper, the most important step is to brush out the excess air bubbles from the center moving outwards. Also, this will help your transfer sheets to get very firm and very flat onto any base. You will not see any bubbles, you will not see any creases. Now very slowly you see this magic and you can see the wonderful, beautiful effect of transforming, and this is how you can create a very beautiful coaster on a plain MDF base which has been single painted coat. Can you see the finish? And also now in the end, once again with the help of a brush, simply gently press it going from center to out. This will help you get the flat perfect thing. Leave it to air dry. Please do not use a hair dryer to dry this. This has to be compulsory done air drying only. Once the transforming has dried completely on the base, we will apply 2 coats of Cadence acrylic varnish, that is matte finish. So this is the best way to protect your transforming on any of your projects. So simply you take little bit of
acrylic varnish and give one thin, nice, smooth coat on top of your entire project. So this is the best way to protect your transforming sheets. Make sure that you allow this first coat to dry thoroughly and make sure it dries naturally without using any hair dryer. And once this first coat has completely dried, you will be applying a second coat. So two coats are enough for protection of transforming, and that will give you a wonderful finish to your project. So this is the best way to have the top treatments once your transforming is done on any surface.
So this is how you can complete your projects within few seconds and gift your loved ones, near and dear ones, on all the occasions the beautiful projects you can create with transforming. Isn't it super fast and super easy? So this is a very beautiful world of transforming, which you can do it on all the different bases and gift your loved ones within a very few seconds. And I hope you all have enjoyed the tutorials. Thank you so much for watching.
To buy these transforming sheets for the Indian buyers, you all can log on to www.crafterscorner.in, and for international buyers, you all can log on to dressmycraft.com. I'm sure once you have them, it's a total addiction. You all will enjoy making them at ease. Have a great day. Thank you.